Welcome to Apps for a Video Tutorial. Today I'll take you through a quick demo on the new community sites social feature included in SharePoint 2013. This is the new SharePoint 2013 site. In order to create a community site in this SharePoint 2013 site, first go to Site Settings, click on Site Contents option given here, and you will be taken to this page. Here below you will find the new subsite option. Click on that. Further, here add the title that you desire to have for your subsite. Enter a description, enter a desired URL. Click on the community site option under the collaboration tab. Further, as shown here, check the required user permissions. Check in the yes or no box to decide whether you want to display the subsite created on the quick launch bar or the top link bar of the parent site. And finally, hit the create button. Subsequently, you will be taken to the new out of the box community site. You can go ahead and start new discussions here. For that, just add the subject and body of discussion topic in the box given here. A discussion can be marked as a question when it is created. Further, you select the category and then hit the save button. Here, as you can see, is a new discussion I just created under the general category. Members can post replies to it or also like the discussion that I've created. You can have a view of hot topics discussed by the members here. Members can also have a view of discussions carried out by me as a member here. Another interesting part in the community site are the community tools. It allows you to manage your discussions, create categories, and create badges. Badges are gained by achieving specific reputation points, or you can also manually grant badges to other users. Moving further, I feel reputation is yet another interesting and nice feature included in 2013 community site. There are few configuration settings when it comes to community reputation. The member has a reputation score as well as a metric indicating points required to move to the next level. Reputation helps identify experts within an organization. Also available are two other settings under the community settings option. That is the established rate and reporting of offensive content option. When offensive content is reported, the content is removed from view. Then you have this what's happening section on the right hand corner of your site. Here you can have a quick view of members in your community site, discussions happening, replies, so on and so forth. You can also have a quick view of the top contributors of your community site. Further, the members page offers you a view of who joined your community or was invited to join. This page can be sorted by top contributors, new members, etc. Another interesting feature is the category section. It helps organize the community discussion board. Each category list item has a name, description, and picture. For more information, log on to www.appsforum.com. Thank you for watching.